Hi, my name is Caroline, and this video is about 3D printing bias tape makers for people sewing face masks for hospitals in the fight against COVID-19. With the COVID-19 crisis, there is a huge shortage of cloth face masks, and a lot of people are dusting off their sewing machines and making cloth masks in their home. I'd like to start off by recognizing an amazing group of volunteers, and that group is the Atlanta Sewing Masks for Hospitals Facebook group. There are three co-founders in total. They are total strangers who met on Facebook. They currently have a network of over 7,000 people who are now making about 1,000 homemade fabric masks a day. These are all homemade fabric masks, and a lot of them have the N95 filter on the inside. They are all 100% volunteers, and they give away these face masks. Now, I don't have a sewing machine. I was looking for other ways to help them. Some of the masks have elastic around the ears, but the hospitals are now asking for masks that have straps around the back of the head. This requires something called bias tape to make the strap. In the quantities, they're now making 1,000 per day that they're making these face masks. The bias tape is a bit expensive to buy, and they are now making their own bias tape. Thus, they need this little tool called a bias tape maker. We found the Thingiverse model for bias tape makers. I started printing them out. I gave about 15 out the first day to people in my local area. The people that I gave the first batch to were very appreciative, and they said it worked perfectly. Before they had this little tool, they were making bias tape by hand, and it was taking forever. This tool significantly sped up their production time. Then I went back to Atlanta Beats COVID, the organization I'm volunteering with, and the sewing Facebook group, and said, how can we provide you with more of these to speed up production? ABC pulled together, we printed out about 150 of these things in about 2 days, and then I got them to the central location for the sewing admins to distribute out to their network. Now, I'll show you where the files are and what my settings were in Cura. Let's go to AtlantaBeatsCOVID.com, and I'll start a screen record right now. And here we are at AtlantaBeatsCOVID.com. I'm gonna go over to DIY and scroll down. And I did cover face shields in a different video. I will link to that below if you're interested in making face shields. So here it is, 3D print bias tape makers. Click make it, and it takes you right to the Thingiverse website that has the files. There is a 4 centimeter and a 5 centimeter bias tape maker. I'm gonna hit download all files, and then I'm going to open this up in downloads, and I'm gonna unzip the file, and then we're gonna go in, and then we're gonna double click on files, and you're gonna see there is 4 centimeter bias tape half .stl, 5 centimeter bias tape half underscore edited .stl, and then 5 centimeter with wings. When I first started this, I printed all three just to get started. The one with the wings took forever to print, and nobody said, I need the ones with wings. I just stuck primarily to printing the 4 centimeter and the 5 centimeter without wings. Now we're gonna go into Cura. First of all, when you're in Cura, I highly recommend going into extensions, update checker, check for updates, make sure you have the latest version of Cura. And the other thing I recommend is if you don't already have Octoprint set up, highly recommend Octoprint. It is a game changer. I have several videos on my channel on Octoprint. So I'm not gonna go into all of that setup right now, just giving you a couple pointers as we go through this. Now I'm gonna go back to my files, and I'm gonna drag and drop the 4 centimeter and the 5 centimeter bias tape makers onto my plate here. And then I'm gonna go into my profiles. I'm gonna go through and select draft profile. And that is a layer height of 0.2. And they have more specific print settings here, no supports, no RAFs, resolution 0.24, infill 10%. All right, perfect. That is what we're going to do. Go back to Cura, layer height 0.2, I'm gonna leave that. Infill density, let's see, what did they say? 10% infill, all right, let's do 10%
infill,
and then of course print temperature. You can absolutely print these in PLA. All of the ones I printed were all in PLA. Temperature, I'm gonna leave that at 200. Print speed, you can print at 60 or lower. Yes, I wanna enable retraction. Yes, I wanna enable print cooling, and I do not print with supports. You can print with a brim if you'd like. I've got good adhesion on my plate, so I'm gonna hit skirt, and then I'm gonna hit slice. And that was how I printed the first one. So I would highly recommend printing one of each to start it off with. And it would take an hour and 26 minutes to print one of each. Now, what you can do after this is I would print a 60-40 ratio. So I would print, the larger ones were a little bit more popular. I did have a couple people say they needed the smaller ones, but the larger ones, I would multiply that by 5. So there'd be 6 of those, and then I would take the smaller one and then multiply that model by 3. So then there'd be, you know, 60% large ones and 40% small ones. And so after you print the first 2, make sure your printer is in good shape. I will admit I did have to do some repairs in my printer to get this to work because I had to kind of dust off my 3D printer as well. Now it's ready to go. And this for me was pretty much an overnight print. And so let me slice it and see how long it's gonna take to print this. And according to the Cura, it will take 7 hours and 34 minutes to print this. So for me, this was about an overnight print, and that's what I would do. And that is the settings on Cura. That's where I found the file. And I hope you will consult with your local sewing group if there's a sewing group in your city that is in need of printing masks and you want to help out with your 3D printer and they are doing the ones with the ties at the back. Consult with them, see if they need these items, and try to partner with them. I hope you'll consider that. And that is what I did for the tape makers. Now, I made a separate video about printing face shields. I hope you'll check that out. I will leave a link in the description field below as well. And thank you so much for watching this video. I hope that you and your family will stay safe and healthy through this COVID-19 crisis. Please subscribe, and I'll see you next time. Bye now.